मैं बोला मैडम हमें या ऑडिबल क्लियरली मैं बोला मैडम मैं बोला मैडम आम आई ऑडिबल क्लियरली
यस यस सर
या थैंक यू मैडम राइट गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट टुडे द सेम सब्जेक्ट एनाटॉमी फिजियोलॉजी एट द बिगिनिंग आई वांटेड टू गिव यू सम ओवरव्यू राइट फ्रॉम द बिगिनिंग दिस वन लास्ट क्लास फॉर यू so I wanted to review the things happened earlier. Now look at this syllabus. So unit number one. If you have any doubt after this review, you can tell me. Then we can cover it up. Okay. So how to make it and another way to facilitate learning or another way to learn and how to prepare for that examination. If any out with you how to present it everything we'll discuss at the end today so in the first 1 hour we'll concentrate on this subject next 1 hour we'll go for other clarifications okay regarding the subject related thing right but unit number 1 tissue and cells over okay group of tissue epithelial tissue muscular tissue connective tissue and their functions everything we have completed and skeletal system bone and the joint both together called skeletal system already we have discussed different types of bone short bone long bone irregular bone flat bone which are some typical example and different types of joints okay one as major classification fibrous cartilaginous as well as synovial joints okay and the different types of synovial joints and the tendons and ligament you know the meaning of what is tendon what is ligaments structure connects the bone to bone and muscle to bone okay then circulatory system structure of the heart over the cardiac cycle composition of blood pressure blood vessels hematological system nothing but the composition of the blood okay and the functions we have discussed about the different cellular elements and their functions arteries veins capillaries digestive system starts from the sometimes called alimentary canal or digestive tract okay start from mouth to anus we discussed everything I have given you some type assignment talk about the liver pancreas okay so you would have finished it or else I'll tell you a little later okay the both things will come behind that's what I give you that idea you have to prepare it okay why did I say that I'll let you know purpose of that okay good next respiratory system passage already discussed pharynx okay physiology of respiration external respiration right and I have given you another assignment right small kind of or prepare yourself with some writings of endocrine about endocrine system okay so here those two important glands we discussed earlier liver and pancreas they also includes here in the endocrine system though they have some exocrine activity these two has endocrine system activities too okay so that I ask you to prepare something if you had done it very good you didn't do it we'll discuss here later this class okay then the nervous system over central nervous system peripheral nervous system and autonomic nervous system sympathetic and parasympathetic system right functions of the sensory organs I given you the assignment you are more frustrated on that one many questions many queries pour in but unable to answer because little busy with other works because each and every time I cannot answer for that queries but now I'll tell you a clear idea wait for another 10 to 15 minutes okay good and urinary system over okay and the left thing is here posture one word is called posture inactive posture and active posture, ideal posture. Okay, I think it's a very general subject. You know very well about it, I think. But I'll give you an overview of that one. Okay, there are a lot of things are available. You can study that. But I'll give you some overall idea about the posture. So already you are practicing a posture in the name of asanas, right? So same way we have some generalized meaning of posture discuss now. And we have reproductive system. Oh, okay. Reproductive system, puberty, menopause, testis, uterus. Okay, we'll try to give you some more we want that part. Okay. The last 50 unit already told you, I'll give you another one more type of overview on how to present yourself into that. Okay. So today, can I start with the posture? Okay, I'll give you some posture. Right, we have able to see my screen, share screen. Able to see that, madam, Mabel, madam. Someone answered in chat box. Okay, yes, okay. Bavitra has said yes, okay, very good. Okay, we'll go ahead. Okay, good. Oh, yeah. Posture. What is posture? In if someone asks you what is asana, we'll give you some answer. No, the same answer you can put it here. Okay, but I'll give you the different terms given by some people here. Posture is a position in which we hold our bodies. Okay, while standing, sitting, or in the lying down. Okay, this posture supported by the right amount of muscle tension against the gravity. Okay, coordinated action. Many muscles and external supports are involving in that. That means we are sitting in a chair. Chair gives a broad base to set yourself or position yourself in a posture. Okay, and to keep your posture, many muscles are actually working on that in order to hold your position. Okay, that is called posture. Okay, this posture maintaining of muscle reflexes. Okay, unconsciously this thing happens. Reflex, you know very well, it's involuntary autonomic function that every muscle has a kind of small sensory organ called muscle spindle. Have you heard about that muscle spindle? You can see now very you can see here, this is a muscle fiber. Inside the muscle fiber, some muscle fiber or bundle of muscle fibers has a small organ, sensory organ called muscle spindle. Okay, they are the stretch receptors, okay, that give constant feedback to the central nervous system, how much amount of stretch happens in that particular muscle or group of muscles. Okay, this information process in the central nervous system and giving motor information to the target tissues to hold it. Okay, to hold it. So we have some kind of muscle spindles in the many muscle groups, okay, especially in the larger muscle groups have many of this muscle spindle. Okay, good. So according to your syllabus, we are move on to the types of posture. Okay, there is a posture called inactive posture, one type. Second type is active posture. Okay, inactive posture is a body adapts while resting or during sleeping. Okay, like lying posture. During this time, what happens? You are minimizing all major muscles activities. Okay, so when you're standing, all major muscles to work actively to hold your position in standing. Okay, or in the sitting position or in some other position. But while resting or sleeping position, my muscles are working, but in the sense here, major muscles are taking rest. Okay, but major muscles are not taking that much amount of work. Okay, give me a moment, I'll be right back here. Give me a moment, all audience, please give me a moment, I'll be back. Right, student, I'm back. I'm sorry that disability. We have some disabilities here outside, so I wanted to solve that one, right? So inactive postures, okay, we move on to the active posture. This active posture have two types. One is dynamic posture. So how you are holding yourself when you are walking or moving or running like that. During that time, some posture has to be maintained for a short while, okay? That type of posture are called dynamic posture. Static posture, you know very, very well, and the name itself, static means stable at one place, okay? Like when you are sitting and standing. This posture or static posture. So how to improve, control your posture, this in a syllabus type. In syllabus, there is a how to control it, okay? Be mindful of your posture. So in what, how you are positioning yourself, like same like what you have doing in the asanas. Stay active in sense here, healthy lifestyle, okay? So doing exercises, proper exercises, okay? Right amount of energy expenditure that keeps your muscle fibers active and strong so that you're able to maintain the proper posture, okay? Maintain healthy weight. Excessive weight causes excessive increasing the load to the muscle groups, okay? Wear comfortable and low heel shoes. It is mainly for the both, okay, not only male or female, okay? So sometimes you used to see some people have boot and wearing boots and running, okay? It's not suitable footwear. So some girls or some ladies, they used to have high heels, okay? You should avoid it because they make some alteration in the normal posture position of the body, okay? Especially in the high heel shoes, that gives excessive curvature in the lumbar region of the spine, so that your back will come back and come behind. That will happen. That will impact the plate in between the vertebral bones. So usually these people who wears high heels might have the back pain due to wearing the high heel shoes. Okay, so you should avoid it. Make sure your work surface at a comfortable height. And good ergonomics. And now it is a technology, a science. They are designing different types of comfortable positioning based on the biomechanical principles. Okay, for like a chair, they have some lumbar bends or lumbar supports. In car, they'll give you neck rest. Okay, these are some ergonomics. Okay, this ways we can control the good posture. Okay, so simple to understand here, what is bad posture? Some people may ask you, okay? It's a misalignment of your body, okay? Or you should align your body proper position, okay? There is alignment to each and every part of the body. Like your vertebral column has the S shape, S curved shapes, okay? You have to maintain the S curved. In the thoracic region, there must be S curve. And lumbar region, there must be S curve. But increasing the curve unknowingly or purposefully for some other reason, that will lead to the bad posture. Okay, good posture always gives you good attitude, good look. Okay, and then you'll have a sense of comfortness, a sense of fulfillment. Okay, but bad posture always leads you some kind of negative things. Okay, so in order to avoid those things, I don't want to get into the psychological way, more of this physiological way we should talk, right? Good. This all some idea about the posture, right? Do you have reproductive system? We change on the reproductive system, right? Before that, do you have any doubt on that? Faster? I'm little faster, I know, because this one last class we have given. So we need to complete everything here. Do you have any doubts in faster?
Sir, I have a question, sir.
Yes, go ahead.
There are some accessories available to correct the posture.
Yes.
Is it
advisable to wear? Yeah, advisable only. The thing is, posture correction, anatomical posture correction. Okay, by birth, if you have, there is only possibilities. You have to seek the medic's help. Okay, by birth. Okay. So they should give you, because natural disalignment can be corrected by the medics, okay, by surgeries. What do you say? Oh. These accessories, okay, due to your not you, I mean, commonly I'm talking, okay, due to bad healthy lifestyle, okay, sitting in the couch long time, okay, that may create to some kind of bad postures like kyphosis, lordosis. There are many names, flat foot, okay, like that. But there are some kind of accessories like a foot, foot arch. Some people may not have a foot arch. In shoes, they can place it, that kind of things, okay? And this will be definitely help you, help you to prevent some injuries while walking, while running, when you're involving the sports. Now, there are so many belts and other things are there, okay? So for temporary purpose you can use it, okay, but the ultimate remedy is only you should actively participate some physical activities. You should develop your strength, muscular strength and other aspects. Thereby you have to improve your fitness and you have to maintain the good posture. That's the best way to change yourself, okay? But the following those things, that gives only support, but no correction will happen. Got the point here? Correction. There is a corrective physical education. That means you should do some kind of activities like yoga therapy or some other therapy, whatever way, the physical activity, whichever you like it, you can do that activities and you can improve yourself. Okay. Don't always rely on those things. Okay. Got the point?
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Sir, I have something to add here. You are in that slide. I thought I would speak about it. Which I recently learned. My understanding is static postures are postures where you go into the asana, you stay there for a while, for few breaths, or hold the posture for few breaths.
So, madam, may I know who is this talking? Who am I talking to?
Anandi, sir.
Anandi.
Not only sitting, standing.
Yes.
It is also you stay in a posture for holding the breath or breathing for a while in the posture.
Yes, you are correct. And the thing is, your view is completely yogic view. Okay. Here, I am talking about a physiological way. We have to talk about the general people, not the people who...
Okay.
You got the point
that's
here?
That's what I wanted to know. You had something.
Yeah. You are correct. You are correct. So, those people who are doing the yoga, you are giving some kind of clarification. What is... There are something, okay? Yoga, I cannot call yoga, but I can call asanas, okay? In the part of yoga. Most of the activities... Most of the activities, I can say even 100% of activities, all postures, we used to call in English, postures, are maintaining some time only. But I don't know, in the few years of development, yoga, and this prevalence of yoga, they make like what we say, dynamic kind of movements. I don't know, I really don't know the exact meaning of that one. If you make the same thing, the gymnasts are more yogasana people like than the yogi. Yoga, those who practice yoga. Am I correct?
Yeah.
They are sketching like anything. Okay. They are called sometimes, they used to call us as, contortionist. Okay?
Yeah.
So, in that aspect, we are not discussing here. We are giving the general people and the general idea about the culture, some classification people to understand. If I'm sitting, I'm teaching, what position am I in? I'm in static posture. What posture are you in right now?
Okay.
So you are in a static posture, but you are talking about the yogic pattern. It's correct.
Yeah. Got it, sir.
People
got
who
it.
Are practicing in yoga, correct?
Yeah.
Good. Any other doubts? I appreciate your effort to give that explanation.
Thank you, sir.
Any other doubts? Right. I hope we move on to the next one. Reproductive system. So in what way you have to present? Because this is also one large area to discuss, and which has a lot of complex system inside. But to help you out, if they ask any question, how to write in examinations, okay? Right. Reproductive system is a sexual reproduction organs, includes the sexual reproduction organs and many hormones and pheromones. Okay. Just, you know, hormones, you have heard about the hormones. Okay. At the end, if you are, please remind me, I'll talk about the pheromones if you have any doubt. This is a new word for you, I think. Some people might know. If you know very well, you can explain at the end. Okay. Pheromone. Okay. Right. Sometimes this reproductive system called a genital system. Okay. So the genital system consists of different organs involved in the sexual reproductions. Okay. So there are a female reproductive system and male reproductive system. These systems can be classified into two head. One is external sex organs and internal sex organs. Okay. So male sex organs and female sex organs. That means males in external sex organs and internal sex organs. In this heading only, you are going to discuss anatomy, overall anatomy, okay, gross anatomy, not deeper anatomy. We have no time, and time permits, we'll make it, okay? Good. I think you have got it. Reproductive system and a little introduction to it. Okay, here the female sex organs. Someone ask questions. Okay, the female sex organs, okay, the external organs organ is called vulva, and it has different parts. Mons, pubis. Mons means mount. Mons, it's all Latin word. Pubis means pubic bone. Labia majora. Labia means lips. Majora means larger. Labia minora is a minor kind of things. And this labia minora surrounds vaginal and ureteral opening, okay, and clitoris and another organ. External organs is very much homologous to glans penis, okay? Right. These all some external organs, external sex organ of female, okay? I'll discuss later about the male. And the internal reproductive organ of female, this thing first you should understand here, okay? So external organ is down here, vulva, just leave it, it's external things. You can find all clitoris or mons, labia, like that, everything. Okay, this one is called internal sex organ of female here. Okay, so this particular area, okay, this particular area is called vagina. It's a fibromuscular.
Felix, sir?
Oh, okay. Now I'm audible. Okay.
Ah,
now
yes,
I'll unmute it. Okay. Okay. Good. I'll come back again. Okay. So this internal organ, female reproductive organ here, these are different parts inside. We have different parts here. So you should know these things. Okay. Simply vagina, it's a fibromuscular canal. Okay. Lined with the surface of squamous epithelium. Okay. You should know very well that we have discussed about the epithelial tissue, squamous flat like structure. Okay. The inner lining consists of squamous epithelium tissue and vaginal mucus, which has vaginal mucus glands, receives male sex organs and the sperms here, okay? These all main part, the first internal part begins from the vagina. Then next part of this tube is called cervix, okay? Lower cylindrical part of uterus, this is called uterus. The lower cylindrical part is called cervix, which lined with the columnar cells. Prepare the sperm for the fertilization, okay? Once the first sperm released here, that moves through here, that has to be prepared for the fertilization. There are a lot of series of changes undergoes here, this cervix, okay? This one is called fallopian tube, okay? Fallopian tube, I'll tell you the main purpose of this fallopian tube, okay? Next, uterus. This is the uterus in common term they use for the uterus womb, okay? It is a childbearing organ, and here the egg is fertilized. Egg is implanted here and undergoes series of changes over weeks, and the fetus develops here only. Okay, So this activity happens due to estrogen and progesterone hormones. These hormones, I'll discuss about what is estrogen and progesterone. Okay. So another important organ in the female reproductive system is ovary. This is ovary. Main reproductive organ. This one produces oocyte. Okay, oocyte means egg cell. Female egg cell is produced here. And this is the organ responsible for the estrogen and progesterone. When estrogen, progesterone, progesterone, we already discussed here. Under influence of this two hormone only, this particular uterus undergoes many changes, series of changes here. Okay, this estrogen and progesterone influenced by the pituitary. Pituitary secrete another kind of hormone to develop during transformation from the child to adult. That is called puberty. That time we have some kind of hormone secreted by the pituitary that induce this ovary to secrete estrogen and progesterone. Once the estrogen and progesterone is secreted in the female, they get a maturation, sexual maturation here, and they get the secondary sexual characters. These are some idea about the internal sex organ of the female. Okay, here you should remember here, forget just the external organs, vulva, and these types. And we'll go to the internal organs, these most important organs. Okay, vagina, cervix, which is called womb or uterus, and there's a fallopian table. Through this only the egg site is travels. Through this only the in this minute egg cells produced here, they travels here and comes here. Okay, where here only the cell division meiosis takes place. Meiosis and gives one female cell and that travels here after fertilization and implanted here. Then they start growing slowly. That is called fetus. Okay, so this is an overall idea to people who are not familiar with this reproductive system. Okay, we'll move on to the male reproductive system. External sex organ, penis and scrotum. These both are the external sex organ of a male. But we move on to the next. Right, male internal organs. Okay, you can see men, the testes or testicle, one side as single as testicle is a male. This one is a testicle. It's a very important organ, like equivalent to ovaries in female. Okay, they produce the male gametes. Gametes means the haploid cell. Haploid cell means germ cell sometime. In commonly we know sperm cell, okay? That produced here in the testicles. And another important hormone called testosterone, this is a male hormone. This gives the male secondary characteristics. Once it started produced from the testicles, the secondary sex characteristics will develop, like mustache, beard, changes in voices. This will take place after the puberty. This particular hormone is a male hormone, okay? Produced here in the testicles. Okay, so in the testicles, over the testicles, you can see here that is called epididymis. This epididymis helps actually this sperm cell produced here. That is, immature sperm cells are produced here. Remember, this enters into this epididymis, where this immature cells are get maturation. Okay, then get some motility. Okay, then it travels. Next important organ is called seminal vesicle. Okay, here you can get seminal vesicle. But before that, there's a vast difference. This is another tube. Once the matured sperm cell in the epididymis travels here, okay, and reaches to the seminal vesicle. Seminal vesicle responsible for the semen fluid. It's a kind of fluid secreted by the seminal vesicle. That fluid, that matured sperm cells are mixed with the seminal fluid, then it travels here to the prostate. Okay, this prostate is another kind of gland that secretes alkaline based fluid. Okay, alkaline based fluid, it gives more liquid nature to the sperm. this particular alkaline nature liquid helps the helps for the sperm for the survivability when because this alkaline nature travels into the vaginal canal. There is acidic base substances are there that may kill the sperm cells. So in order to avoid and balance the acidic activity, this prostate secreted substances counterbalance that and give some survivability to the sperm. Okay, these are some idea about the male internal sex organs. You should remember testes or testicle, epididymis, and seminal. This is a vast difference. And seminal vesicle and prostate. These are some internal organs. Okay, so it's all overview of the internal and external sex organs of the male and the female. Okay, good. Before that, any doubt you can ask. Right. They may not ask you any specific organ of this reproductive system. They may ask you general, right, about the human reproductive organs or human human reproductive system. Like that, they may ask you. To have an overview, you should write sex organs, different types of sex organs, and internal organs. Right. Shall we move to the next? I think no question. Good. So there is one topic already given you to prepare yourself for the your examination point of view. Okay, so hormones or endocrine glands, did I? Okay, so now you should have you can open your mic and you can tell me how many of you have prepared this one and have some knowledge about it. Or type in your channel.
Actually, pancreas, it maintains the sugar and salt balance in the body.
Which one? Tell pancreas. Pancreas, correct. Pancreas and the liver, already I told you. Now you can see here, even in the endocrine system, you can see this liver and pancreas. Be able to see this picture here? That's why I did tell you that you have to prepare that there, then I can teach you here, okay? But this also one complex and very large area, okay? Still many facts are unknown, still, okay? Research is going on and keep on giving us a lot of ideas, okay? Very good. Pancreas, what type of hormones they secrete? Do you know that? Pancreas? Someone answer me.
Insulin, sir.
Insulin? Any other?
Insulin, glycogen, somatostatin.
Insulin is one everyone know, is a common thing everyone know. Yeah, right. There are other secretion also available in the alpha cell and beta cell. Have you heard about these things? What alpha cell secretes? What beta cell secretes? Very good. However, some people have taken some effort. I learn and know. How many of you have undergo or tried to learn this?
Have not heard, sir. Alpha cell, beta cell.
Okay. That's I'll explain very overview. Okay, but here I already told you if liver means it takes more than 5 to 6 classes. Okay, I'll give you overall idea now. Okay? So some people may not know that how to present yourself here. You should know. That's what I take this to give you some overall idea. Okay. Longerhans, correct. Sakrika, correct. Good. Have you seen your syllabus? What all the organs are available? I mean, endocrine system. Yes, first, sir. Always they start with the pituitary. Okay, remember. Okay. They always, because that pituitary is the master gland. They used to call it the master gland. And the size is very smaller. Here you can see here, later and under below this hypothalamus, you can be very like a pea size.
Sir, previously it was a pituitary gland. Now they are saying it is hypothalamus is the master gland.
Master gland, because I already told you, keep on changing because the vast area and it goes on number of changes. Okay. Hypothalamus, some people say, another hormone, that hormone is a pleasure hormone. Now they say it's not a pleasure hormone, it is a motivational hormone. Okay. So I'll give you only idea. Okay. This is not information right now. What I say, it's correct. Okay. Keep on changes based on the research taken under that particular area. Okay. No pituitary gland. Mostly this pituitary gland is called as a master gland, and they controls many organs many organs through secreting many hormones. Okay, so GH, should I say the GH? Already you have prepared means it's very good. What is GH? So
growth hormone, sir.
And, what about TCH?
Thyroid stimulating hormone.
Yes, now we should understand the yes, stimulating. Okay, they are not a. So if thyroxine need to be produced, what we need, pituitary gland has to be secrete thyroxine stimulating hormone, okay, ACTH.
Adrenocorticotropic hormone.
Yes, adrenaline related to okay. Only thing, the terminology is very hard. Okay, function you can easily write it. Okay, because that the word itself will give you clue. You got the point. Growth hormones related to growth. Okay, stimulating hormones, that thyroxine related things. Easily you should remember it. Okay, so what you should understand here, thyroxine stimulating hormone, or adrenocorticotropic hormone. Adrenocorticotropic hormone, okay, or what we call growth hormone releasing hormone, growth hormone inhibiting hormone. So many hormones, the prolactin,
lactate, for breastfeeding, yeah.
lactate, milk production, okay, oxytocin. Right, then melanocyte stimulating hormone that involves in the color pigments of the cells. Okay, learn this pituitary gland here. Now move on to the hypothalamus. Okay, one of the important organ, as someone tell, now people are telling this is the master gland, but I don't know. Now we should understand here, this also as equal as a pituitary gland. Now previously people did not give much importance to this kind of hormones. Now new hormones and new studies shows this is more important than pituitary gland now. Okay, dopamine, now it is very familiar among people. What is dopamine? It's another hormone secreted by the hypothalamus. Dopamine involves in what?
Dopamine.
Just now I gave you that idea.
Motivation.
Yes, it's usually the people used to call it as a pleasure hormone. Okay, well, if you feel happy, this hormone. Now the study changes into people, motivational related things. Okay, so many hormones are secreted here. Look at the names. You have to remember those names. Okay, next we move on to the thyroxine, thyroid glands. Okay, what about liver? Bile is another secretion involves in the exocrine system, not in the endocrine system. Remember, those secretions, bile secretion of liver, correct. But that involves in the digestion, okay? That's not act as a hormone. Hormone is what we call messenger work. Neurotransmitters, like that they work. But this bile used as a chemical molecule to break down the lipids, okay, mechanical aspect. Clear? Good. And the stomach, you can see?
Melanin, sir.
Melanin, okay. Now, swim out of the stomach here. Stomach, gastrin, geraldine, histamine. Histamine already in blood also the same name came. Histamine, somatostatin. Okay, these all you should remember only the terminology here. Okay, important hormone I'm talking. Okay, so we move on to the kidney. Adrenaline, adrenal secretes adrenaline, involves in the flight or fight. That autonomic nervous system I spoke, no? During fear or something, if you want to take a decision on fight or flight, that function under the influence of the adrenaline. And as well as they have another few more hormones also secreted by this adrenaline.
What about cortisol, sir?
Cortisol, I'll tell you. People sometimes use to call stress causing hormone.
Okay.
And in this one, I forgot to tell you, insulin is, you know, what is glucagon? Glucagon and another, glucagon is another hormone secreted here in the pancreas. They are increasing the blood glucose level. But insulin push the blood glucose into the muscular and saving as a glycogen form. Okay. But when our blood glucose goes depleted, the glucagon activates and increase the blood glucose level here in the pancreas. And the kidney, very important things. The renin, one of the important hormone, and another one is erythropoietin. Already I discussed about the erythropoietin, okay? They involves in the red blood cell production. So this sense, this when hypoxia condition, hypoxia means low oxygen level in the blood, kidney sense it and they produce erythropoietin. This induce production of more red blood cells in the bone marrow. Okay, the other important endocrine gland produces other hormones like that's related to gonads. Male sex organs and female sex organs. They androgens, estrogens, progesterone. These all here in the all reproductive system. Okay, so here testis secretes many. Ovary and placenta secretes estrogen and progesterone. Uterus produces prolactin. Here you say prolactin here. Okay, this stimulating here and relaxin. And this uterus also produce many other hormones at the time of fetus release. Okay, undergoes many type of contraction in order to push the fetus down. Have you got only the glands listed in your syllabus? You can write it. Okay, rest. Also, thousands of thousand hormones produced in the body. Okay, by many cells. So we cannot discuss everything, but only the prominent hormones and the prominent organs glands that secrete the hormone more than enough to present yourself in the examinations.
So one doubt, sir.
Yes, good.
Yeah, that like LH hormone is connected to in that sugar or in sugar level.
LH.
Yeah, luteinizing. Sugar. It is connected to sugar or insulin levels.
No, all the other hormones depends on the secretion of the pituitary here. Okay, pituitary is hormone. Okay, each mainly they controls the and give signal to the other organ to other gland to secrete other hormones. Okay, main thing is regulating function. Okay, that regulates the other organ to secrete a particular thing. Okay, that may mostly the pituitary glands related to the stimulation, regulation and control. Okay, so whatever hormones FSH or MSH or ACTH, or LH, whatever it means. Okay.
Okay. Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Kidney.
Kidney involves in the urine formation, okay, that is called excretory system, not endocrine system. Here, that kidney also secretes many hormones, like main things, renin and erythropoietin. Calcitriol also is correct, but here erythropoietin is very important hormone secreted by the kidney that involves in the red blood cells production. So now look at your, any more question? Look at the only overview, okay, no need to write much idea, okay, more about hormones, because you cannot write all the hormones here. So a lot of disturbance, some people are talking, could you mute yourself?
Yeah, or vocal center, tell it
out. Clear? Someone discipline. If any doubt, you can type in chat box also. I'm going to look at it.
Sir, previous year question paper, sir.
See, I already told you, oh, this year is a new pattern here, okay? So we are not related to exams, okay? And we try to get it, but even they are not giving us a syllabus, okay? Even Tamil and English, BAC people, I keep on requesting them to give the syllabus to the Tamil and English. And they are not giving us, okay? Again, I put your request also to them. We need a previous year question paper, okay? We try to give you, okay? If they facilitate us, we definitely will give you. Well, they in the sense for the university, okay?
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Right, and the reproductive system, we talk about the pheromone, okay? The pheromone is the same like a hormone. Hormone works inside the body. They give changes and works as a neurotransmitter or messenger things. Messenger, give us a messenger stimulations. Pheromone also is the same thing, but they are not working under the individual, but it passes into the other individual and makes changes on the receiving individual, okay, pheromone. Like some insects you would have heard about, they emit some kind of substance, smelling substance that spread in the air and attracts the male or female. Okay, that's called pheromone. That particular hormone does not make any changes in the insect that produces it, but it reaches the receiver, will get some physical and physiological changes. Those kind of chemical is called pheromone. Someone asked Anusya related to this diabetes control, okay? Okay, here the LH, it is scientific and clinical approaches, we cannot do it now here, okay? You should understand here. Because clinical approaches, we may not do it. I should not give you. Okay. So that try to avoid these clinical things. Okay. Each and every tablets or something, they have kind of chemical molecular substances inside. Okay. Based on the research finding, they used to give us. Okay. But here, sometime this will change immediately after new finding comes.
Got it, sir.
Someone asking liver hormone. Okay. So clinical aspect, you can give, pose a question. The thing is, I cannot give you the clarity to over it. Okay. So the medical practitioner is the right person to give you the clinical ideas here. Okay. You try to understand, you ask them, they'll give you.
Okay, sir.
Sugar level, mostly people depends on the insulin and related and other, what do you say, the tablet related thing. I can give a big remedy. Okay, if you're involving the exercise, one important medicine called exercise. Okay, exercise, sugar means it goes, the blood glucose level goes high. Okay, that's a dangerous one. Even goes down also dangerous. But when you're eating, the blood glucose level never goes down, okay? So it goes up only, but that the ability to push the glucose level down, the insulin works here, okay? But exercise, push your or burn your carbohydrate and the glucose, carbohydrate equivalent to glucose, the small molecule of the carbohydrate is called glucose. That level can be reduced by involving in many activities, okay? Especially endurance kind of activities. Okay, that exercise help you to reduce the blood glucose level. Keep yourself always active, involved in physical activities. Definitely you can maintain your sugar level without having any insulin injection or your tablets. Okay, but you should schedule yourself the amount of work and amount of energy spent. Okay, if you are scheduling properly, you can calculate every movement using of some glucometer or something, and you can maintain your blood glucose level better way by involving in exercises, okay? Not rely on your chemical intake, ingestions. Right, this particular liver hormones, someone asked liver hormone. Liver hormones have many hormones, okay? They controls and regulates all the sexual hormones, okay? And excessive hormones are neutralized by the hormones secreted by the liver. And they also involves in the many hormones the red blood cells, okay? These red blood cells, in the worn out red blood cells are degraded in the liver only, okay? They have again undergoes many changes and separates and segregate heme part and iron part. Everything is segregated after they kills the worn out red blood cells. For inducing that excessive things, there is another kind of hormone secreted by the liver and regulates those activities, okay? So many names are there. That's why I'm telling, just go through and just have the terminology and the names of the hormone. That's it.
Okay, sir.
Right, with that, 1 hour over. Next 1 hour, we are going with your assignment and other ideas. If anything left your right, you just go through your, all of you, different groups are there. Go through anatomy physiology syllabus page. You can open it and let me know if anything tough to understand. Okay, you need at least an overview, we'll make it.
Sir Felix, sir.
Yes.
This is Vivekanandan, sir.
Yeah, please. Go ahead.
All the MSc students have prepared the assignment. It seems five sensory organs.
Yes.
Where we have to send this assignment?
Submit. That's another. Give me 10 minutes. I'll give you the way. Mode you can. Submit.
From yesterday itself, we are going on.
Yeah, already told you Friday, I'll let you know. I've seen many messages because I have no time to message everyone. More than 100 messages, how can I possibly know?
Yes, sir, we understand. We understand.
That's what I want to make a common announcement. This is the right platform to everyone will hear. No? That's what
I make. Okay, sir, okay. Yes, thank you.
Right. You have made assignments, okay?
Yes.
So assignments helps you to understand something, okay, without teaching, right? Here, I wanted to give you some overall idea of the skin. Skin has how many layers? You can answer quickly.
Three layers.
Three layers, okay, three layers. But actually two layers, hypodermis is not a layer actually. Okay, hypodermis mostly is a fat tissue that is called adipose tissue. Hmm? Only two layers, epidermis and dermis. Dermis part has something and epidermis part some kind of layer, different types of layers. Okay, mostly epidermis, dead cells in the outer layer, and they have the keratin. Have you written about keratin? Keratinocyte?
Keratin, yes, sir.
Mm, yeah, melanocyte. I'm just giving an idea how to prepare yourself, right? Melanocytes related to the melanin. Melanin is the black color pigment.
Skin color.
Okay.
Skin
not black color, not pigmentation. Okay, that's pigmentation. Melanocytes. Okay, and there is many type of cellular debris are there. Okay.
Good. Basket cell.
Pardon me?
Basket cell, Langerhans cells.
Yes. Yes. Many layers. I already told you we are looking at only the larger part of the epidermis. Okay, epidermis has many layers. Okay, you can see that one. Okay, but no need to mention everything. Okay, so here important the two part is epidermis and dermis. Okay, dermis part has the internal things like blood vessel, nerve endings, and hair follicle. Sweat gland,
protein, collagen, elastin,
sebaceous gland. What is the use of sebaceous gland?
Sweat glands.
Sebum secretion.
Network of fat and collagen cells. Sir. It consists of network of
sebum secretion, sir.
Sebum. That's oily. That secretes oil. But sometimes people say my skin is oil. Okay, oily. So that particular oil secreted by the sebaceous gland. Okay, so someone answered. That's what people are here with scientific background. They can give us more ideas. So we have to make use of them to give us. Okay, good. That oil may not be secreted by that gland when during a high cold time. So we'll get dryness in the skin and the erector pili muscle.
Goosebumps.
Have you seen that? Goosebumps, but always keep the things during goosebumps. It erect hard and makes that hair straightening. Okay, that gives support to the hair follicle. Okay, these are some ideas about the skin. Okay, you can make a function. Main function is protection of the body. Give from the first line defense. Okay, to the physical defense to the body. Clear? Okay, so I'll ask you some more question. I want to know about your preparation. Functions of ear.
Functions of ear, sir.
Ear.
Yes, sir. Regulation of temperature.
Balance and
balancing.
And hearing.
And hearing.
Hearing is a balancing common function. Everyone knows. Everyone
balance.
Knows. Balance. Second balance. Thing is balance. How balance. The how the balance is balanced. How the air maintains the balance.
Semicircular canals.
Yes, exactly.
Walk of equilibrium.
Yeah.
Vestibular balance.
Yeah. Anvil, stirrup, and hammer.
Cilia, kinocilia. Yeah, there is a hair-like structure over that suspended in the fluid.
Yes.
That gives us the position. Okay, while we are static or the dynamic. Okay. But most of the people may not know that air has another important function that maintains the body balance. Okay? That gives constant feedback to the central nervous system. So the central nervous system able to maintain our muscular activity in order to maintain our balance. Okay, these are all important thing. Okay, so some commerce background people may not understand. Try to understand the words, at least balance or this hearing. These are some functions by the ear. Okay. So any other question from the non-science background? Yeah. Right. One more thing. I have seen some people have sent us some assignment. I see that personally. Eyes is like cameras. Okay, correct?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Camera is like eyes. Okay, camera is imitating the eye. Okay, not eye never imitate the cameras. Okay, you have to say the word technically. Okay, so any other doubts? So,
next no question, sir.
Pardon me?
Any other questions, sir?
Yeah, that's what I'm asking people. If people are there, they will hear. Any other question? I think I speak to someone who is wet, okay? Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
So he knows a lot of anatomy than us.
No, sir.
Yes, sir. He is answering all the questions.
Yes. He's a wet. I saw his idea. He's a wet guy.
So for exam,
mm-hmm.
Yeah, we should write the parts and we can just write the functions of the particular organ.
Listen,
right?
Yeah, you're correct. And it depends on the question, how they're asking.
Okay.
The question needs that answer of some picture illustration, you should put it, okay? Or else if you wanted to explain something through that one, you can put your drawing. Okay.
Yeah, if they ask for one organ, we can put it in detail.
Remember, but this particular course is not much importance to the anatomy, I don't think. Okay? Because yoga people, they know very well, they'll make generalized question, like write about the human reproductive system. Generally, they leave it. Okay, whatever you write about the reproductive system, automatically carry some marks. Okay, they may not go very minute part and ask the function or the anatomy of the minute part.
Sir, later, can we just have a review on the cardiac cycle, sir?
Cardiac cycle? Cardiac cycle, each beat is a cardiac cycle. Okay, there are a series of events takes place to make that one particular contraction, okay, and relaxation. Okay,
yes,
the contraction and relaxation does not happen in a one shot. All the entire heart does not contract entirely at once, but rather first they contract atrial contraction, then blood pushes into the ventricular, then ventricular contract, blood pushes into the two important large vessel. One is pulmonary artery, another one is aorta. Okay. By the time when it contracts, that atrium again relaxes. By the time that atrial refilling happens, the same activity repeats again and again. This series of activities called cardiac cycle. Remember?
Okay. Yeah. Yes, sir.
So there are some other terms related to the heart. So I'll discuss here in the fifth unit. Okay. Already I informed you. What is the effect of yoga on a different system? That's a question here. Unit number 5, if you're able to see that, okay? So I have some physical education background. Physical education and exercise perspective, we have a lot of literature gives us scientific evidence and the changes takes place due to exercises, okay? But yoga said, if you see that, now it's a grooming up. So we have to see many literature talks about this area, because most of the things are theoretical, given by people, by experience, not by the research. Okay. So I'll give you some idea how to present yourself in the examination. Effect of yoga on circulatory system. Okay. This is the question. Let's write about the effect of yoga on circulatory system. What will you write? People are telling, no, while doing some asanas, people keep on telling, this improves this movement improves that. Explain that. That bit also can help you here.
Sarvangasana. Sir, Sarvangasana.
Many asanas. Yeah, what is the impact of the asana on the circulatory system? That's the question here.
Yeah, the asanas keep the body in warm condition. which facilitates the flood.
It's a general term, sir. You are talking correct. It's a general term. I'm talking very clearly here. Circulatory system. What is the effect of yoga on circulatory system? Get the point? Warm is related to skin maintaining the warmness. Urinary system maintains the temperature. Okay. Sweat regulates the temperature. I'll give you idea. Okay, so you should have clarity. That's why I make in exercise perspective. I'll tell you. Then you can convert the joints. Yoga perspective. Okay.
Reduces cholesterol. The joints.
No, that's cholesterol reduces. I'm telling very clearly on circulatory system. Circulatory system consists of heart and the blood vessel. You got the point here?
Okay. Lowers the blood pressure.
How?
Intake of oxygen.
Intake of oxygen. Okay, correct.
The energy level will be increased.
Yes. May I get that, Mr. The veterinary doctor here?
The nutrients are distributed to the cells properly.
Correct. Circulatory system. Where is Mr. Krishna Sai? Could you open your unmute your thing and you can tell something with this?
Yoga increases the posture.
Madam, that is not a physiology. Okay.
Yes. Blood circulation is without strain. The velocity of the flow can be changed voluntarily.
Yes, yes. You should arteries talk and about veins some of these. Correct. You should talk
there
about
there is no adaptive changes in blood vessels.
Yes, you should talk about the physiological changes. Remember, okay, posture improves, develops. No, you should the general and the end of the result. Okay, but you should some changes in the physiology.
So it reduces the heart rate.
Heart rate reduces.
Yoga improves the heart rate.
Do you have any research evidence, madam?
Actually,
hello, Felix, sir.
Heartbeat slows down when we do
Mr. Krishna Sai, correct? Practice.
Hello?
Krishna Sai, correct? He said Krishna Sai?
Sir. My signal is getting cut, sir.
Now you're able to hear me?
Yes, sir. Clear, sir.
Question is here, unit number 5, impact of yogic practices on anatomy and physiology. What they may ask question in down there. Impact of yogic practices on cardiovascular system or effect of yoga on cardiovascular system. What will you write? You have any idea?
That is my assignment, sir.
No, assignment. Just give us some idea how to people will get
Okay. So all these yogic practices, they will use the joints, sir. They will always use the joints because joints inside the joints will have a blood circulation.
No. Confine yourself with the circulatory system. They'll ask you question, effect of exercise on the circulatory system, effect of yoga on the respiratory system, effect of exercise on digestive system, or effect of exercise on hematological system. They may ask a general question, effect of exercise on different system. Now it is easy for you to make it, okay? But sometimes they ask you effect of yogic practices on circulatory system. Confine yourself within that one, okay? I'll give you some more idea and we'll finish it off.
Do you want me to write these things, sir?
Write. If you have any idea, you can share here. Okay, how to write an examination.
Sure, sir. I will make it. I will take this as my assignment. I will submit it to you,
okay,
sir.
Okay, then. I understand. Right. Now I give you some idea here only on the cardiovascular system. Okay. So in exercise, we study this in exercise. You can convert into the yoga practices. Understand? Good. We used to call a cardiac output. Do you know what is cardiac output?
Yes, sir. Amount of blood pumped out from the heart in a single cardiac cycle.
Single contraction is a stroke volume. Is a stroke volume. Cardiac output is the amount of blood pumps out in 1 minute. Okay.
So it's one minute.
Okay. It will be calculated number of heartbeat in number amount of blood pumped out from the left ventricle. You got the point here? Two things. Okay, cardiac output depends on the heart rate as well as the stroke volume. Okay. Cardiac output is equal to heart rate into stroke volume. Stroke volume is the amount of blood pumped out from the left ventricle in one contraction. Okay. It's about 70 milli.
Yes, sir. Okay.
So how many times the heart contracts and relax cardiac cycle or got the heart rate? 72 times. 72 into 70 milli. How much it comes?
How much it comes?
How much amount of blood pumped out in 1 minute? About 49 milliliter. 40. I mean 5 liter. We'll round off it to 5 liter. Okay. At rest, in a sedentary and a normal human being, what happens? Okay. Heart pumps out 5 liters of blood from the left ventricle in a minute. At rest. You got the point here? But involvement in continuous and endurance activities, I'm talking about the physical education exercise side, okay? I'm not talking about the yogic side, okay? Continuous activity, or continuous endurance activity like 45 minutes and plus exercises per day or weekly 4 or 5 times over a period of 3 months, minimum of 6 weeks, that yield you some result here. Okay. What happens? The heart rate goes down, recorded as below as 60 feet and
per like less. Usain Bolt, you are thinking for fast training.
Yes.
Cardiac training. I can understand, sir. What are you saying?
Not only sir. I'm giving an idea to everyone, Mr. Krishna.
Sorry, sir.
So it goes down 70 to 60 or 50 due to the strenuous activities effect. Why this heart rate goes down here? Because heart contract efficiently so that more amount of blood goes up. I mean, every time in normal time, only 70 ml will go up. Means once you involve in exercises due to strengthening of the cardiac muscle, the contracting efficiency is increases. That pushes off more amount of blood. Instead of 70 ml, it increases into the 100 ml at rest. Okay. If a stroke volume increases 100 ml and heart works only for 55 times, 55 into 100, how much it comes? 5.5 liter. Okay. This is the effect of exercise. You should talk about the effect of yoga into circulatory system. It's only one aspect. If you do, you're able to follow.
Shall I give some more points?
Yeah. Do you have any? I'll give you time.
Okay.
Other people are there, and I'll give you time. Right? Is there anything? Do you able to follow all of you? Follow me.
Yes, sir.
Okay. This one yes, in this yes, type, you should make it. Okay. How yoga influences the heart activities, or increases the cardiac output, or increases the stroke volume, or reduces the heart rate, I mean cardiac cycle. For example, today my heart rate, resting heart rate, they used to call resting heart rate is 49. Today I see mine below 50% because of continuous involvement in the exercises. Okay, so like this, then this one particular part. And the second idea about the the influence of cardiorespiratory system due to continuous involvement in exercise. Atrial and venous AV2 differences. Carbon dioxide and oxygen levels. Okay, the oxygen carrying capacity of the blood increases because every time in involving exercises, okay, so the blood supplies more number of oxygen to the working muscle groups. What happens? There are number of hormones, number of chemical receptors. Realize it and increasing the production of the hemoglobin. Okay, so the amount of hemoglobin each red blood cells increases, thereby the picking up more number of oxygen in every time. Okay, it's all effect of exercise on blood. The point here, but, you should explain how yoga is influencing the cardiorespiratory system or cardiocirculatory system. What the point here? Right. If anything you wanted to tell, now I can explain it. Someone ask me, someone tell me that they wanted to add some more things. Go ahead.
You have said it, sir. You have said it.
Okay. Someone say that.
Sir,
they
to... any other improvement in the lymphatic system because of the yoga?
No, yoga, that's why I'm telling. We have very, 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 very less researchable evidence towards the yoga. Okay, now, past few years, only the physical education people doing the research on that. I'm very frank to say here. Okay, like Komala is one of, she's a physical educationist. She has done her, research on yoga. And some people are doing, and now only very few research are there, okay? But the researchable evidence we should have to give a literature, correct? So what you people always say is here, yoga reduces this, yoga reduces that. It is experience, okay? But we should prove it by some research things, okay? So we are waiting for it. People are now more research going on in that area. We'll see. In another few years, we'll get it. So you can use this exercise effects into the yoga, but I treat the asanas as one of the exercise. I treat. It's my personal opinion. Don't take it any other way. Okay? I'm not against any people here, but you can practice it. Okay. Yoga in a sense more of psychological way of practices than the physical activities. Okay. So how it going to come, how this the physiologically controls it. So already I told you every physical activities is related to our psychology. That is psychosomatic. Right, someone Sweta Swarnagauri improves heart rate, slower heart health. Okay, you can write like that.
So let me read some points from previous notes.
Already told you, you can open it. You can say.
Okay. Due to constant change in chamber size, the cardiac muscle wall is properly exercised without strain. Complete filling and emptying of the chambers is ensured. The autonomic control of heart is rested and heart rate is reduced. This helps in more efficient cardiac functioning and that's metabolic right, demands.
Cardiac, more efficient cardiac contraction that helps you to pumps out, eject more amount of blood and which also has the relaxation capacity of the heart muscle also increases. So when it relaxes, more amount of blood can enter. Okay. Sometimes the people who involves in the continuous regular exercises, they have called hypertrophy, heart hypertrophy. Sometimes that heart hypertrophy is called athletic heart, okay? They have a larger heart than the sedentary people. Sometimes even doctors misunderstood, they have a larger size of heart, okay? Later they found they are the sports person, they are the physical, they are involving physical activities, you know, physical activity for a long time, okay? These all some development takes place inside. You got the point here? So you are making it very generalized form. It is very good. Okay, you can write it like that. They'll give you mark. Don't worry. They may you all the other people also can do it. Okay, what about
sir, one more? Sir, sports person, continually doing exercise. No, upper yoga body, heart pump, heart one the kamipana, pumping kamipana.
Pumping capacity one the pumping ability one the adhigamakum, efficiency of the pumping one the adhigamakum. But number of working cardiac cycle on the particular heart patents on only. அது வந்து கம்மி ஆகும் அப்படின்னா இப்போ ஒரு ஹார்ட் வந்து ஒரு நிமிஷத்துக்கு வந்து 72 times அது வந்து ஒர்க் பண்ணுது ஆனா நீங்க கண்டினியூஸ் எக்ஸசைஸ்னால என்ன நடக்கும் அப்படின்னு பாத்தீங்கன்னா அது வந்து எனக்கு வந்து இங்க ரெக்கார்ட் ஆனது 49 ஒரு மினிட் நைட் தூங்கி எழுந்திரிச்சு போது என்னோட ரெஸ்டிங் ஹார்ட் ரேட் அப்படி எவ்வளவு டைம் தான் ஒரு நிமிஷத்துக்கு ஒர்க் ஆயிருக்குன்னா 49 times தான் ஒர்க் ஆயிருக்கு பட் என்னோட கார்டியாக் அவுட்புட் நம்ம பேசினாலே கார்டியாக் அவுட்புட் அந்த கார்டியாக் அவுட்புட் நெவர் பீ காம்ப்ரமைஸ்ட் ஓகே தி சேம் அமௌண்ட் ஆஃப் பிளட் பம்ப்ட் அவுட் from the heart, even it contracts only 49 times. But the amount of blood comes out each contraction, no? That is about 70 milli. But instead of 70 milli, it goes up to 100 milli. So automatically, the amount of blood required by the cellular level is compensated by increasing the stroke volume, but by reducing the heart rate. Okay, this is the concept you should understand. You're
confused, sir. The heart rate is the
confusion.
ஒரு நிமிஷத்துக்கு
ஒரு மைண்ட் அண்ட் அதர் நியூரல் ஆக்டிவிட்டிஸ் த்ரூ யுவர் யோகிக் பிராக்டிசஸ் that may improve. Okay, but people says we believe some Guruji, some people says like this happened. Okay? But scientifically no proven evidence till now. But there are some people experiencing it, but without books or without any research evidence, I cannot say no. But there are benefits, but you can make it, you can write it. But I cannot give you this book says like that, okay? If you say a cardiac output in trained and untrained, if you type in Google, you'll get many literature.
Okay. Like basically, na sportsman da sir. Adala ana po yoga pannumbodhu konjam flexibility zone and iduvum konjam nammukku
yoga la vandu flexibility engla flexibility ingiradhu oru component of the fitness engla porthu varum okay va flexibility is one component. We have strength, speed, endurance, okay? Among that one we have flexibility and body composition, like that we have many components of fitness, okay? But yoga has a more gives one particular component is flexibility. Definitely I agree with it, okay? But the other metabolic rate what happens inside the cellular level, that has to be studied.
Okay.
சொல்றேன்
இருக்குது
அதை நம்ம யூஸ் பண்ணுவோம். யோகா இஸ் அ கைண்ட் ஆஃப் பேட்டர்ன் கிவன் பை வாட் வி சே கிவன் பை சம் குருஸ் ஓகே ஆர் இன்டர்ப்ரெடேஷன் பட் ஐ டோன்ட் எக்ஸாக்ட் மீனிங் ஆஃப் தட் ஒன் ஓகே ஹியர் ஐ கேனாட் கிவ் தி என்டையர் கிரெடிட் டு தட் யோகா பட் யோகா வி இன் ஸ்போர்ட்ஸ் யூ ஆர் டாக்கிங் அபவுட் ஸ்போர்ட்ஸ் அண்ட் யோகா ஓகே பட் ஸ்போர்ட்ஸ் ஹேஸ் தி பர்ஃபார்மன்ஸ் ஃபேக்டர் பட் தட் that performance cannot be achieved through the yoga may assist to improve your performance. If I want to go for 5000 meter run, 5 kilometers yesterday I ran able to run only 30 minutes, okay? But in Olympics they run it in 12 to 14 minutes. We cannot imagine it. By doing yoga, can we say that we can improve the endurance? We can improve the endurance good by doing asanas. Okay, we can, but not to the performance, up to the maximum performance level. Okay, but is there any other process? If you are doing it, prove it, or if you are produce someone like that, people will follow you, and you'll give us some more literature, like science. So yoga, you should understand here after your practices, how your practices influencing our body physiology. Okay. That's very important. You people, mainly I can blame you. This yoga people never concentrate on this area, anatomy physiology. That's their biggest lacuna I can see. Okay, they should relate it into the science here. So automatically people will believe you everywhere.
No, moreover, there is no proper records maintaining as mentioned. See, that is the main reason people are easily able to, what is that? இது வந்து இது யோகா இஸ் நாட் தட் மச் கேபபிள்
ஆர் நோ ஐ cannot say yoga because there are many practices. Each and every country has their own traditional practice. If you go to China, they have their own kung fu or tai chi or whatever maybe. If you see the tai chi almost equivalent to this, but movement was there very slowly. They have some mental practices also, okay? Here the thing is we should connect this physiology into that, okay? Or else you people should do some researchical work with the use of your yogic practices, and we have to record it.
It has to be coming under a scientific community. Only then the world will accept.
Yes, and the problem is here that also what you criticize, correct? Is it correct, criticize? But I feel that people always treat the yoga more like a spiritual than the science. That's the problem.
Yes. Yeah, it becomes a religion then.
Yeah. That's what people, whatever they say, they are not treat as a science. They treat as a supernatural. That's a problem here.
Yes, sir.
So always you can give supernatural explanation, not a scientific explanation. That's a, I mean, a struggle you have to prove yourself. Am I correct, Mr. Vivekananda? Correct?
Yes, sir. But the thing is, mm-hmm. nowadays people need everything in a faster rate. Today I'm taking a tablet, means tomorrow I should see the result. For the other way, I'm not blaming or something.
No, you are not blaming. I do understand, sir. There are a lot of misconception here. I do attend many, because yoga is part of physical education for us. Okay, so many people used to come and talk to us. They always talk about yoga therapy or natural therapy or whatever therapy means. They always immediately started blaming the allopathy. Okay, one particular party here. Okay, I'm not blaming. Okay, immediately blaming it. One particular. Simply they say don't take vaccine.
No. The mentality of the people is like that. Mentality is like that because yoga will not immediately give. Today I'm doing yoga means tomorrow I cannot see the result. It is a
commonly the common. Perception over this yoga I'm talking, okay? What they think, don't take vaccination. But I'm not agree with that, actually. If rabbit dog beats me, there is only possible here, anti-rabbits, we have to go with rabbit vaccination.
No. When rabbit dog bites you, sir, Felix, sir.
Yes, sir.
You should not go with vaccine. You should take immunoglobulin.
Immunoglobulin is another globulin. I mean, protein in the blood plasma. And we have to post-exposure vaccination, correct? 0, 3, yes, 7, 14, and 28. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Immunoglobulin is what he mentioned is in order to slower the process of spreading, they use the blood plasma. They take immunoglobulin part and they used to give what we say, Mr. Grasai, that one. What is the process of using that muscle and they inject that immunoglobulin around that the dog biting areas and reduce the spread of the rabies virus. Okay. Very deadly virus. Okay. Deadly virus. Once you got the symptoms, there is no possibilities of survival.
Yes, sir.
Not like a corona, like a COVID. It's deadly. Okay. We are 12:05. Okay. We are discussing many things. Okay. However, good time I had with you. Any doubt, okay? Any doubt, you can ask me. I'll open another 5 minutes. And I want to give you one more idea to other people. PG Diploma Yoga, PG Diploma Yoga, Naturopathy, and Diploma Yoga, Naturopathy. Okay? BSc, don't worry. You have this particular subject in second semester only. Okay, don't worry about that one. We'll give you more time to learn. Because we know your position now, you are new to this degree course, so that will give you more leniency towards that, okay? And the other four groups, okay, please look at your syllabus. If anything left, leave me a message. I'll give you the entire video or any kind of PowerPoint recordings in the YouTube one that one for education YouTube channel. You can go and see that one. Just leave what topic you wanted to learn, okay? Just I'll post that entire video into that one. You can see that one. But you should tell us what the topic we need to give you the ideas. Okay, like I said, blood grouping. Some other syllabus has a blood grouping, ABO system or RH system like that. Okay, if you have any difficulty or you need something to be taught, let us know. Then we'll put that video into the for education website. Sorry, YouTube channel. And assignment on that particular day. Okay, and the assignment on five system. MSC people, the other people, you can write for some more time, then we'll collect it. Okay. So, last class in this anatomy, then other communication, I'll connect through that WhatsApp or your mail group.
Okay, sir. So, if you grant us 25 internal marks, we are very happy, sir. Thank you very much.
Yeah, we are here to promote. Okay, we are here to help. We are here to facilitate the learning. Okay.
Thank you.
Something happens in our learning changes happens inside. Okay, definitely we are here to help you out. Okay, don't worry. But try to follow the instruction given by us. Okay, most of them they never follows. Okay, I already told log in with your mail ID. You more than 40 people never do that work. Okay, and I'll give you some idea when you are entering here. Put only your course. People again typing their name and the course. Okay, and then I'll give you some Google form to you. Please return it on time. Then we can arrange yourself and we'll put your attendance and your marks and we can send it to the university. Okay, so probably tomorrow you'll get some form. Just to fill that your fees details and your class feedbacks. Okay, we'll send two forms to you. You have to send it back. Yes, yes.
Felix, sir, I have paid the fees, sir. You said you have to send.
I'm telling you, tomorrow I'll leave you one Google form about your fees payment. I'll leave you another Google form, like you have to fill that, your class and feedbacks and how much you have participated. Everything you should, your own feedback. Okay? These two forms, I'll leave it tomorrow. By course-wise, you have to send it back. Okay. Tomorrow, I'll leave you that. Based on that, your response only, we'll send the mark and your attendance to the university. Okay.
So no, sir. I have two forms with me. One student copy, another university copy.
Yeah. Now there is no possibility of sending those copies to university or to us. Okay. That student copy is your record. You have to keep it. Okay. University copy has to be sent to the university. But wait for some more days. Then we let you know when they communicate to us. Or else you can call directly to the university and you can get some ideas on that one. But we need your proof, the payment proof. Okay. So we'll take a photocopy or scanned copy of that.
Sir, my fees details, I'll send it to you, sir. WhatsApp, sir.
Sometime may not see because many messages are pouring. I cannot see that one. Okay, I'll give you some mode how to submit that one. I'll tell you. Then you follow that one. Okay,
sir. All of you.
Right.
Can you share?
Regarding assignment, listen, regarding our assignment, okay, you should think, you can post that one into the WhatsApp group, MSc group, means you can post all of those things in the MSc group, okay, in that WhatsApp. I tell another person who's helping me, he'll, order that and organize and give me, okay. I'll put all those things into the MSc group or PG Diploma, put in your own group, PG Diploma in Yoga, put in your own group, okay. Right, Rajeshagar, one who sent that one, the first assignment, your assignment is not clear.
Sir, this is Telma. Shall we post the assignment now, sir, in the WhatsApp?
Yeah, that's why. I'll give you the time. That's why I'm telling you. You can post it, but post it before 3 p.m., okay? Or before, make it a 4 p.m., okay? Post it before 4 p.m., okay? After that, we cannot see that one. That phone is not always with our hand. Only some few times we'll spend. Okay, before 4 o'clock, you post all the assignment to that one.
Assignment in the MSc Yoga group, sir.
MSc group, put in the MSc group. PG Diploma Yoga, put in the PG Diploma group. Okay, like that, their own group. Okay, take a clear
Felix,
photograph.
Sir, thank you.
Mr. Rajeshagar had sent the first, but still we are unable to see that. And he had put much effort to draw that skin. He uses a lot of pencil, color pencil, other things, but not very visible to us. Okay.
We have class in the afternoon, sir.
After we have class, yeah.
Okay.
Sir, tomorrow we are having class, sir.
Can I tell you today evening? Okay, it depends on the portion and the teacher are going to complete. Okay, if they complete it, no class. If they complete, yet to complete means we'll have one class at least.
Sure, sir.
Sir, how Felix, much mark does the assignment carry, sir?
Assignment, we have for theory paper, every theory paper have a 25 marks, okay? So we'll based on this condition, this situation, we'll decide it later. Okay, but your assignment and your quiz already sent, and I'll send some more quizzes also. Okay, for the psychology and yoga therapy and yoga naturopathy.
Okay. Yeah. So we have got only from your this thing, sir. Anatomy only. We have got the assignment.
Okay, okay. They'll give you. I'll let you know because we might have one more skill. Okay.
Yeah.
Might have, that time we'll complete everything. You have to organize yourself. No, but the problem is you people are not as organized as we expect. If you say something, there are many things. Things are happens. Good.
Felix said this is Vinod here.
Vinod, iPhone, correct? You have your ID already. Many times I told you. Now you got into my line. Tell me.
I will change, sir. Sir, on the theory study material, only the soft copies of two subjects have come. Any update on the others?
Mr. Vinod, they have sent, I have posted everything into the MSc group in Google Classroom. Whatever they sent to me, everything is available right there. Okay, but for BSc, they didn't send a Tamil paper, English paper, yoga. There is a yoga natural, there is a yoga therapy. Okay, they didn't send, but we take our own effort and put it. As soon as they give us, we'll share to you. Okay, if they give us a hard copy, we'll let you know. You can collect it also.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Felix, sir, immaculate. Konjo late evening, varaikum kudunga, sir.
We'll make it a 7 o'clock.
Time extension.
One final change. Usually I don't do that. Okay, one final thing. Because 6 till 6 o'clock, 4 o'clock your class. Then 5, 6, 7. You have 3 hours to make it. Okay. If you're not writing it, you can write and put it. Okay. But then that means all of you listen. You put your assignment from between the 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. Don't post before that.
Thank you, sir.
Each and every page.
You have your own conversation. That goes pages by pages. I have to collect your assignment of scrolling down your messages and I have to collect it. Okay, I have a lot of difficulties. Okay. Do what I say, please. Okay, do what I say. Okay. Post your assignment between 4 p.m. Between 4 and 7 p.m. Okay, 4 and 7 p.m. Don't post it earlier.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Okay, then. Okay, good. Right, Bavla madam.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Yes, madam. Just give them just one minute, and then you can end the meeting.
Okay, sir.
Can we leave, sir?
Yes, yes. All of you, thank you very much. You can leave.
Thank you, Felix.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.